Thank you. Welcome once again to the Arts Hall, where we'll be doing some more painting in the not too distant future. Let us firstly transfer to that. Secondly, we'll stop that. Thirdly, just gotta find it because I forgot to open it today. I forget to open it regularly. Right. Make sure we whip that down a bit. That's the ticket. There we go. A little bit of music. A little bit of music in my life. A little bit of music instead of my wife. I sold her for a chiptune. And she was not fucking happy. Right, okay. Next up, let us unveil the camera. The camaraderie that is my camarada. Right. We're not looking like we're in a terrible position. No, we'll just do that. It should. I just want to double check. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it does do a little bit of something. Might as well. Oh yeah, I think you could just see the tip of it. It's the remote control for the lights, for anybody wondering. I was just double checking and making sure they would ideally stay on. Now, I can never guarantee they're going to stay on because they're not the world's greatest of lights, but you know, we use what we can, how we can, and where we can, and that's basically the motto for life, isn't it, really? Use what you can, when you can, how you can, why you can? No, I don't think you need why in there somewhere. Right. Okay, so is that a... That bloody light is bloody awkward. Right, so... okay, that's looking about right, although I must admit, as usual, that camera seems devilishly far away from where I'm... an optimal working position, which is not what you want. I do need to fiddle more. Whoops. Oh, there we go, that's well, you know. That's slightly more optimal, isn't it? I think, anyway, difficult to know for certain, but... Yeah, there we go, that's a bit more central. Whilst equally being a little bit more... easier for me. So I must remember that. It's a vastly more sort of suitable solution than I ever thought. Alright, what's the other one I was going to use? Yeah, probably that one. So we've got our... I think, apart from the base, which I don't know... Oh yeah, I was going to... He starts in a supply closet. Now, off the top of my head, I don't know what a supply closet floor would look like, but that's basically what we'll need to do at some point, which is... this bit doesn't necessarily matter, but it might be nice to just make sure... There we go. Just make sure the camera is sort of roughly straight. I don't think it makes too much difference, but you know, we have a go. Right, now, decisions. I'm slightly thinking, I feel like the larger brush. On his back, because I've still got too much paint on the brush. Starting on his back will allow it to take off a bit more, I must admit. At this point in time, it feels quite a lot like I might have taken off too much paint, which is always a the unfortunate balance point of dry brushing. Because you do sort of, you need it to apply at least a little bit of paint, because otherwise there's not a lot of point. And this feels like not actually applying any paint, which is really, I've said that, and yet you're carrying on. Well, I'm willing to be proven wrong, as is so often the way. I think we need to realize is perhaps a daft thing to say, but I do get the impression it might be a little bit of something. At least semi on the camera. It's a little bit further away than it's one of those ones where it's like, well, you don't always want to be right up inside your face, because I'm using a large brush over a large area. Possibly one of the worst songs I've ever encountered. Well, that's perhaps a little unfair. There we go, come on. A little bit. Not too bad. Right. At this point, decisions. I think I will try a little bit of this one. Oh, this is the one that's really shit. Yes, I think so. No, 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 not quite as bad, I think. The edges primarily, which is arguably what to do with dry pan. He's got the sort of the hammer, the spike, just essentially working up a bit more of a highlight through the dry brush. I don't know whether it's a good idea or not, it's just, it's the idea I had when I saw that I had the sort of slightly lighter this is Terminata stone. Oh, for anybody keeping track at home, we did some gold fagged brown. It's a bit more orange there, but I don't know. It's weird. I think my screen, the preview of the stream in my screen, doesn't necessarily reflect precisely what the actual recording ends up looking like, but I don't know. That may just be me trying to make excuses for it looking shit. But nonetheless, that was gold fag brown. And in this, at the moment, we are working on a little bit of Terminata stone, which is a much lighter. This one's quite a nice little track because it reminds me of James Bond. It fit reasonably well in a James Bond game because it reminds me quite a lot of the James Bond, the game on the Game Boy. I was going to say, I wonder which Game Boy. But it is actually the one on the Game Boy, the original Game Boy system. Camera will pick that up, but he's had a little bit of a dry brushing, and that not too bad. Quite like, or at least I don't mind the way there's a sort of slightly lighter highlight on the edging, if I can put it in front of the camera, slightly lighter edging on the edges of the hammer, and then also a slightly lighter highlight on the edges of the big mashy spiky ball. For now, really, there's only one job left as far as I can tell. I've not looked after these brushes. I do plan on in the future looking after these brushes a bit more than I have done. I'm in the hopes of sort of actually looking after them and doing more. Trust that one and apply paint evenly. So let's have a look what else we've got here. That one we probably don't. Put this paint away. I probably want to put a lot of this paint away because a lot of this is no longer required, but still. Right, let's have a. Here we go. The old gooping ASMR. Assuming it does come up on the microphone. It might just be picking up the sound of my wrist and arm shaking it around rather than the actual gooping part of the whole affair. Give it there. We could have a problem if I can't open the thing. I said I couldn't trust you. Terms of painting, but maybe. In terms of being a nice little brush to stick in paint and then stick in water. Beyond reasonable. Little teethy pegs. I can't deny. Looking forward to trying to do this. Because it is super tiny. super tiny, and there's quite a lot of them. That's the other issue I think we're going to have here. Bits that might not appear on the camera that often, because basically he has to go in a position where I can see it, more so than where the camera can see it, because it's such a delicate operation there. Thank you. That's a surprise. Well, I think one of those ones where I might just take the win as it looks and stands right now. Because if I continue to fiddle, and also, I don't know if it's an official method, I don't think it is, because it's probably far too risky to do on if you're doing it professionally, I imagine. But this brush here is pretty much completely buggered as a brush, but what's quite interesting is it's got a tiny little curve on the end where I've fucked it up. There's a tiny little curve on the end. I don't know whether that's a bit blurry, but I think you can still see that it's got a little kick on the end of it, and the fact that it's so stiff, I was able to just repair a little bit where the white had gone over. And there's still a couple of bits where the white perhaps has gone over, but he's got uneven teeth anyway. So, yeah. I think we might have ourselves a pretty much finished Monsieur Face of Clay. By no means perfect, but very much sufficient. Not sure whether I want to risk, because there's a slight temptation. I don't know which one to use. Perhaps brown again. I do have a flesh tone one. I'm slightly tempted to maybe put a shade over the teeth, just to bring them back from being perfectly white. I don't know, that might be sort of just a step too far and then end up ruining it. But I suppose arguably I could always paint the teeth white again. If I've done it once, I've done it. You know, if I've done it once, I can always do it again. Theoretically, anyway. So, yeah, fuck it, we'll try it. What other ones did I have available? Light tone, soft tone. The light tone might work. Red, blue, no. Soft. Yeah, soft or light or flesh. Put the knife aside. I think we'll go with the flesh. That's my instinct, so we'll go with a tiny wee bit of flesh and okay. Enough to be able to pop on a brush. Technically, you can probably use a brush. You can probably use any old brush any old time. I do, strictly speaking, have one that's registered as a shade brush. That's a quite a roll, sort of. Get the idea of I felt like there's the other issue I might have, if I might have done this a little bit early. I didn't even really fully consider the idea that maybe, just maybe, I should have let the white dry, but I think fortuitously it had pretty much dried. So, we're Okay. Well, yeah. A bit of mouthwash, a little bit of gargling there, my friend, a little bit of gargling. You should feel good. Slightly tempted. And by slightly tempted, I'm doing it. Adjust. I don't necessarily want them sort of completely sunk, but it might just be worthwhile taking the edge off of the orangey yellow that they were as well. Best bet for the river. He says "Hmming" as he doesn't know what the best bet with the Riddler is going to be. So what we might try and do first, I'll go over that demonette hide. Finest move. Touch up and a slightly extra piece after from this purple. end up touching up the tie as well, which is fine, that's part of the plan. I think I'm going to have to be changing the colour of the tie slightly. Because unfortunately, I mixed up a very bizarre batch of shitloads of mixing previously. And I don't know what that mix was. So I can't really replicate it. So that's probably going to be easier just to sort of go over it with a, what will likely be a slightly different shade, but yeah. I realise the phrase, whatever. But I figured I'd also, I saw there's a little tiny snippet of sock that I feel, because he's wearing sort of a loafery type. Shifting as I thought I was. It's fine. It's difficult to tell how much is visible because I can't really do a full look at the camera whilst also doing a full look at the model while trying to paint it. I think that's right about the other side, because the other side is that straddles the leg right down. And I think the hat, yeah, the hat band is pretty much all there. Oh yeah, I think that's all. Demonette hide sorted. And I think the next step we'll do say whether I should just do, I mean technically it is both, so maybe I could try and do that. Well, actually we will want a bit more demonette. You've got like gaps where the jacket is short, and of course logically it wouldn't all be sleeve, nor would it all be shirt. In that situation, it would be a little bit of shirt, but the shirt would also be sort of slightly pulled back by the jacket. I'm going to try and figure out a way of sort of showing that line to that. I don't think it's going to be all that possible on the other side. Oh, that's my view. I don't know whether I can do it easily from there. There we go. Goodbye. Right. I think we'll do the shoes, because I think the shoes I plan on making easy. We're going with a simple black. I do mean simple black, because it is going to just be plain old black black. No fanciness, just black shoes. Could do like green shoes, but I don't know. I think down on the shoe front, I think he's going to be a bit more just a normal black loafer is the idea. This situation come about, because if they're supposed to be just breaking out of Arkham, how come they've got all of their equipment basically immediately? If they're supposed to be breaking into Arkham, they're stupid. Slight intrigue. Not usually important when you're playing the game, I don't think. back to being the blue, I should have done black socks. Yeah, black socks on a black boat, yes. I feel like that would have been the more sensible option, but... That light should be the other mode. That's the green light mode. That's white as well. I'm not sure. Yeah. A bit of a learning curve, isn't it? Bit of a learning process. Let's try and do the other shoe. Foot is on the other shoe. That's what I should have concerned myself about in the morgue, so probably a nice sort of clinically clean tile of some kind. You care? What a title. Fundamentally, you probably should care, but... Equally, caring is where misery lies. Circumstances call it good, but I don't want to call it too bad either. I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll mix up. Well, I mix up, it's not actually mixing it. Just opening it and dishing it out. But we'll put a bit more Liberator Gold out, so we'll do a second coat of the staff. Whilst also giving me the opportunity with touching up the staff a bit. Might be the worst thing, it's easier to do the glove and then touch up the staff, but I think either or it's going to be a pain in the arse. decide whether this is a real watch, a real gold watch, or a kind of fake gold that he's got on. Using the world's most awkward position to get a brush inside of that area, deal with the rest of this Rolex. Apologies for keep shaking the camera. Can I wrap balls off of this? Lost all delicateness at this stage, and it's going basically over that. And I'll just have to work around that and figure it out. Basically, we're going to have to work out what I want to do with that belt anyway. Possibly might be worthwhile doing that black as well, just to have that gap in the middle anyway. That might not be so outrageous. Is that black still alive? Or am I going to have to make some more? I think the black is just about still alive. Whether I can actually do this. There isn't much in the way of making it worse. Brush is proving a bigger detriment than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be quite a decent one, but it's sort of... past abuses while catching up to them at all times, which is... alright, so bad work when blames the tools, but... to a certain extent, when you're getting paint, and you sort of find yourself getting paint where you don't want the paint to be because the brush is gone off a little to the side than you intended, it does prove slightly problematic. Alright, that one. I'm going to try reapplying the sort of maroonish colour. See if we can... track this. this back to being decent. Basically, at this point, it's sort of hoping that once he gets the green, that'll draw the eye away from all the twiddly dodgy bits that don't look very good. Of course, that is rather unfortunate, though. Not a guarantee. It's because my colour theory was off. It was, the theory kept being that it's more red than purple, but it's actually not. It's still ultimately a lot more purple than red. We've made a possible attempt at replicating it. Plus, I wasn't trying to replicate it as such. I'm going to go over everything, so it doesn't necessarily matter. Look at that. That is quite close. Mephiston red and Zerius purple for everybody once again. I think you can scroll at home. Look at times like this when you suddenly realise quite how fat the hands are. Quite the night. The model is also definitely a bit awkward. As a general, don't make this. It's a definitely awkward model. One of the lesser known talents and skills of miniature painting. Is that... I'm choosing which bits to paint first. Not something you obviously think of as a... not necessarily a talent or skill. Part of the painting process. Very much is. To a certain extent, I don't think I've mastered it, but from my understanding, or from my experience rather, it seems for the most part, the best bet to do mostly the anything that's slightly indented. I'll get that out of the way first. At least I'm doing the slightly surface stuff. Easier to avoid going deeper in. This paint really doesn't seem to want to cooperate today. feud without them. Might keep it from whacking the camera quite as often. Try and make sure it's straight now. So what I'm going to plan on doing is we've got a bit of warpstone glow here, which is a lovely sort of vibrant green. But what I plan on doing is sort of one dab, two dabs, trying to sort of unfortunately rescue the situation as well. But I do plan on popping just a little bit of yellow in there. I feel like that might just make for a nicer, even more vibrant green. Whether that becomes true or not, I do not know, but do the back of the suit a bit more. Because it's nice and relatively simple. There are areas, of course, that aren't going to be simple, but for the most part, I can probably get away with. Might be able to get away with the larger brush, just to make it a bit quicker. problem. Much as I did sort of have a theory behind how much I was mixing in. The exact same shade. Sounds like it is going to be a bit of an awkward task, but never mind. Good evening, Mr. Bluebush. Yes, it is indeed painting. Poorly, but, you know, painting nonetheless. We're currently trying to paint a Riddler. And I've run out of the colour I was using. And so I'm going to have to figure out... trying to match the shade, which is... going to be troublesome. Yes, I mean, in fairness, I think you were present when it was being built, so not of a huge surprise, but yeah, not bad, not too bad, a little overlap. I'm assuming you are officially back from holiday now. How was... I mean, I've seen most of it on... well, I say some of it on Facebook. How was your holiday? Was it a lovely little delightful time you had? I hope so, because, you know, it was a holiday, so... Why is it so... I mean, in fairness... It's vastly better when it is cold and wet, thank you very much. In fairness, I don't think it's that... Oh, apparently, the weather station... it's never fully accurate to the actual house, but the weather station thing suggests it's... 18, which is a lovely cold temperature. It's much better when it's cold. Cold and miserable. Like me. That's how I like my weather. I like my weather like I like me. Let's reapply some more. I'm basically going to go over this one because A, gets it a second coat, and B, I have slightly messed up the mixture, hopefully. The new paint will go nicely with the old one. Oh no, that's too many numbers for temperature anyway. Not a human. You're not necessarily going to end up painting in the crotch, but... the most part, a lot of those models are human. And therefore, why is there not painting in the crotch? Tickling their crotch with a paintbrush. What belongs to you, but others will use it? I don't know. I've never been very good with riddles. Start with the trouser legs, because I think as much as they are a delicate area, they're probably one of the easier delicate areas. So what was the answer to your riddle? Belongs to you, but others will use it. Foreseeable, I suspect there's not a lot going to be visible here because he's upside down. I'm trying to just catch the bottoms of his trousers. I'm also curious, somewhat curious, did you paint anything on your holiday, or did you take a holiday from painting as well? As a holiday from everything else? Or did you sort of piece together like an emergency paint kit that allowed you to carry on feeding the habit? Sufficiently satisfied, at least. And the trousers. I don't know, I feel like I maybe should have done the skin tone first. I'm going to try and blob skin tone into this gap between the watch and the sleeve. And lo and behold, it's not going to go well. Thank you. another talent, skill that I think painters, the really good painters have as well, is the ability to figure out where the optimal poking space is to get into the awkward areas. Be careful where fingers end up. That was a little pint, and that's a bit of a life lesson. I'm focusing so much on the bloody jacket, my fingers are rising up. The riddle would have gone down the path of take rather than use. But the other question you may have missed, if you're sort of back listening. Did you do much painting on your holiday? Did you take like an emergency paint kit with you to satiate the need? Or did you just go, no, this is a holiday, I'm not painting, I'm just going to relax and enjoy myself? Well, having said that, I think you find painting relaxing, don't you? So, necessarily, zero painting, aww. Back on that horse, because especially when that Hulkbuster comes out. I'll have a look forward to seeing what you do with the Hulkbuster. I need that Hulkbuster. A hell of a thing. What gets harder to catch the faster you run? Now that one I'm fairly certain I do know, which is breath. That one's enough of a classic that even I know. Hitting the most awkward part. what, I might just go over some of the other areas first. Trying to assess. Trying to assess precisely the right angle of approach to be able to get in there, which is. Again, it was one of those ones where it was like, I'm going in. Nope, I think this bit needs touching up. Can't quite bring myself to try it, because it just... I was trying to fit around the arm and whilst trying not to catch the shirt. Whilst also not catching the glove is the other key issue. Just hold my breath and stop the brushing. Not advice for anything other than painting, I think. Okay, that's tolerable. Not perfect, but tolerable. Which is basically my standard. Sort of get in with the eyes, and we can then go over with the mask. How's that mask supposed to be? Up and over the nose, okay. Yeah, alright, you should be able to. I think you should be able to. Hoping we can do that. But right, this very second, let's go hat first. purple band, or I have to redo it one other time. Easiest to try and get this time with fake spirits. Once again, for anybody keeping score at home, this is Cadian Flash Time, I believe. I'm just going to use that stripe and no sort of mixing it in with any other colour, just a little bit of water and then apply the Cadian Flash Time. Because that makes sense, quite relaxing doing this painting now, isn't it? So you lose yourself in the design. There's a certain level of stress when you're trying to sort of do the finer detail, but for the most part you do end up in a bit of a zen spot of doing it. The back and forth struggle between the paints. Back and forth in between, oh, I've overdone it, now I've overdone this one, I've overdone that one. Basically, that was it. One stroke. Oh, it's gone reasonably well. That's it. Put it away. Don't try again. Once you find it's got a tolerable result, that's it. Boom. You leave it. And do it again. Nice little. Pop on that. Okay. is. We'll do a quick cheeky dip and go. What we really want to do is just cheeky dip and go. Little top jumps. Not perfect, but I don't think it's one of those ones where I think every time I try and reposition it, one way it goes the other. I don't think it's worthwhile trying to fight that too much. I'm going to move on to his hair, see if I can't just dab out a little bit of hair on him, and then it will be back to a bit of green for the mask, and that'll pretty much be most of his sort of basic colours done. I plan on doing a bit of I've got a green wash which I'm hoping will wash nicely over the suit, but other than that I might try and put a little bit of purple wash on the purple areas, but going to be a troublesome one to try and slot in. This is very much not the brush I'd intended to get my hands on. That's the rush I intended to get my hands on. Again, for anybody keeping score at home, this is Dryad Bark. I'm using Izzy's hair colour, a nice dark brown. Understand that concept. Well, I've fucked it. Good. Good, good. Slightly concerned. What was that? Oh, that bloody thing. Thank you. There's a good few points needing touching up there, but... Hair has now been applied. In my mask time. And yeah. One half went quite well. The other half, not quite so much. Just managed to repair the nose, which was the key thing. And now there's also just a little bit of that demon that I need to somehow manage to slip over the hat and far away. If you look at his picture, you can see he's pretty much white-eyed there. So that's kind of what I went for, and kind of what I did. Basically, that's it. I mean, it's not exactly the world's most, well, that's pretty much just a green backside, but that's, you know, you can see the staff a little bit more. But that's pretty much finished. We'll probably add some depth with some rock wash in a moment or two. But the next step, I don't even know if I really, really want to do it. That one may sort of show as purple, but I'm thinking it might go quite nicely if I use the Liberator Golder again. But yeah, there is a just... I don't know if I want to try this. Because this is very much going to be... Oh, no, it's gone wrong. Let's take it all back. Oh, no, it's gone wrong. We'll have to take it all back. Which could be slightly sort of annoying, truth be told. But anyway, there is a tiny, tiny sort of indent of the question mark on his hat. Now, in the card, they show it as a bit of a sort of peculiar purpley colour. I'm going to try in the Liberator Gold, based on the fact that the cane is in the Liberator Gold as well, but I just don't really know how best to approach this. I don't know how to approach it, but it's gone okay. Leave it. Get out there quick before you ruin it. Don't know how well it will show up, but I'll give it a very late try. Display it again. Oh, actually, yeah, no, it does, because it's got quite a high contrast. You can sort of see. And from that sort of distance, you can see it does just highlight that question mark surprisingly nicely. Surprisingly nicely. Okay, so I was tempted, and I think I did mention it, I was tempted, and I did get him ready. I'm going to try and do a bit of two-face, I must admit. By the time I put a bit of wash on my boy Riddler, I think it will probably be calling it quits as such. I don't think there'll be much in the way of Two-Face, but he'll probably be the next project. Assuming I carry on sort of doing it, we shall see. Right. Let's turn that around. What's that one? Mid-brown. Start with trying these might have slightly higher drying times, so I might need to be patient with it, which is not my strong point. Not my strong point at all. Being fairly liberal with this wash, I don't know how liberal you're supposed to be, but so we're just trying to get it all up in him, really. But my Talisman. I think this will be the last job because it took the clay face one quite a long time to dry. Flesh tiny one on the gold areas as well, because it'll be like a bit like Aglax Earthshine, I don't know. I don't think I want to let it cool too much, but otherwise. Stop settling awkwardly, which I prefer to avoid whenever possible. I've accomplished most of what I wanted to accomplish today. One final, and this isn't anything to do with it, this is just testing. I think it, crucial one is it helped me slightly more, which is awesome. Right, so I'll put that flesh down out to remind me that I wish to do fleshy duns. So, we have now got I'm going to call him complete. A finished clay face. And for people who weren't present last week, the hands, his implements, and his feet were all done in a darker brown. I believe that was Mournfang brown. And then his main body was done in Scrag brown. And I actually did wet blend down, so there's a wet blend where the two browns meet, and it came out surprisingly well. It really did come out surprisingly well, I think. It does look seriously quite well blended. Then we've dry brushed in gold fag brown. I suppose technically we shaded with a mid-brown army painter shade, and then we dry brushed on the gold fag, and we also dry brushed on some kind of stone. Oh, it was this one, Terminatus stone, just to really pop some highlights on the sharper edges of the bore, and then we did ceramite. In a ceramite white teeth with a flesh tone wash from Army Painter again, the flesh tone. I did say earlier, and I chose to do it, so it's my own fault, but I might try and just poke a bit more brightness into the eyes at some point. For now, I'll leave that. Because I wanted to take it back a bit because of the with the shade, but I've realised actually I might want to just because they now sort of mix a little bit too much, and you can see he does have relatively bright eyes, so it may be worthwhile just trying to make those eyes pop again. But I must admit, the teeth look quite nice, and the flesh tone I think did do a rather nice job of sort of darkening where they meet the clay, whilst also slightly taking the edge off the white, which is quite good. So yeah, clay face is pretty much finished. And then we have, still slightly drying I think, we have our Riddler, who is actually looking surprisingly good, considering the troubles with trying to fit everything in. Key things to note, I think, is possibly that arm, where you've got the shirt-wrist combo, that I did pretty much did myself. Watch as well. Oh, that's Clayface's card. Not that it makes a difference. Might as well have his name behind it. So yeah, there you go. And hopefully, once that wash has settled, it might end up looking even better. Or it will look even worse, I don't know, one of the two. We shall have to wait and see. But yeah, there'll be flesh tone put on to Riddler. And as I say, I might just punch those eyes. In fact, do you know what? Let's try and just do that now. What the hell? No, I'm not gonna lie, it might all go horribly tits up because I might suddenly flip it in the wrong place, but I've got a theory. Not necessarily the best of theories, but I've got a theory. Let's see if one or the other might be better. But then again, do you know what? He's got even more sort of dramatic eyes now. Yeah. I think I've ruined it. It's fine. I can always try again at some point, but one of those age old ones where you go, you know what, I can just do one. Oh, no, I shouldn't have done that one more thing. Sometimes you need to learn where to stop. It's a crucial skill, it's a crucial talent. Right, anyway, let's, I must admit, I was tempted to suggest doing a raid, but I don't think it's usually worth it, so we'll just pop that off. Probably a horrible noise, isn't it? Right, let's drift off the Chip Jones, and now we'll go to the interim slideshow for a moment or two. Just double check if there's anybody left. Well, apparently four gathers. Are you a real boy? Because if you are, thank you for following and thank you for watching. I supremely appreciate it. I know I'm not supposed to call you out technically, but just for context, there's been a lot of false follows recently. So seeing you actually in the sort of users in chat thing is quite is almost surprising, because I'd begun to assume all new followers were false followers. But yeah, hello, welcome. Shall we? Might not be hugely worth it still. Let's see who's online. Oh, chaos mode. That in chaos mode might be worthwhile. Probably not huge. That's the fella. We'll start the raid and see how many people. I think one. Is it going to stick to being one? Yeah, I suspect it is. I don't think it's. I don't think we'll bother. Anyway, thank you for watching. Be back Wednesday, I suspect, unless something of note happens tomorrow that I decide, oh, I must do something. But chances are slim. It's just going to be a hodgepodge on Wednesday, I suspect. So I will simply say cheerio and sod off. That's the general gist of things. Cheerio.